contestant number four in the team. This is Anneliese Vass.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Can you share with us a little bit about your platform?
My platform, Learning Through Leaders, is a platform to help students learn how they learn best and being able to incorporate the seven different learning styles and teaching students about each one of those and incorporating them into their schools so that each student can have an equal, incredible opportunity so that they can learn best.
What are those seven different intelligences?
There is linguistic, which has to do with words. There's logic, which is math. There's visual, which is seeing. There is oral, which is through music or through speaking. There is interpersonal, which is social. Intrapersonal, which is like kind of isolated. And then also there is, I for some reason can't remember the last one.
Well, I'm a kinesthetic and I remember that one.
Thank you. It was always my struggle because I was typing it out and I was like, I don't think this is a word, but it is.
Yes, I need to touch things in order to learn. So how do you teach the teachers? How is that process going to work?
I will bring depending on who I'm talking to, if I'm talking to younger students, I'll have games and quizzes and a presentation about each one and being able to teach them through activities because that's how younger children learn best so that they're not taking notes like all bored. And so being able to have them learn in different stations, doing different things, standing up, talking to themselves, having the lights off, or having someone talk to them and having them learn best that way. And that way, the teachers can learn from my experiences.
Can I ask what brought you to have this as a passion?
I was diagnosed with ADD when I was 6 years old. I've had it my whole life. And it's been a very hard thing for me to learn how to study best. Each different subject, I have to do different things. Listen to different music or take my notes differently. I color coordinate all of my notes. And being able to realize that that is something that I have just naturally done, and there's a lot of students that don't naturally figure out how they learn best, and they just copy everyone else. I wanted to spread that so that each student can have an equal passion for education.
Who was your favorite teacher in your life, and why?
My favorite teacher ever was my third grade teacher, Miss Bonanno. And everyone called her Miss Banana. And she really took control of the classroom when she needed to. And I had all of my friends with me, which was amazing, but she made sure that each student was understanding what they were being taught. And when we did projects, each student got to choose what they did for a project rather than being told this is what you have to do.
Tell me about a compass room.
A compass room is something that I have worked with my school on, and it's a smaller room, definitely not as big as a classroom, where there are different ways that students can study or take a test. We have whiteboards lining the walls. Our walls are colored blue because it is the most calming color. There's tables, there's places you can sit on the ground. There's ways that you can listen to your lessons, and there's a teacher in there, a learning specialist, who helps students who don't understand material understand them better at their level.
Tell us about your future plans.
I have lots of future plans. I've been kind of planning my future since seventh grade when my brother started looking at colleges. And I would like to go to college, hopefully at U of Tampa, on a beach volleyball scholarship and double major in biomedical genetic research and vocal performance.
Why beach volleyball?
I'm short. It's just a fact. I'm a very short person. I'm only 5'4", and if you have ever seen a volleyball player, they're like 6 foot or taller, and so beach volleyball allows me to be shorter and still be able to play at a higher level because the jumping is harder, but everyone is kind of playing at the same level, and we don't have six people on the court. We only have two, so me and my partner, we're both very short people, and so it's really easy to just communicate with that one other person and be able to make plays that way.
So I see that you flew a private plane. How was that experience?
Very nerve-wracking, to be honest. My brother has wanted to be in the Air Force since he was probably knew how to say airplane. And so he's had a lot of experiences to be able to fly private airplanes with different people at our local airport. And so through those connections, I was able to fly Cessna 157, which was amazing, but very scary because I didn't want to hurt anyone.
What's your favorite book?
My favorite book is a book called The Selection. It's the first one in a series, and it's about this future dystopian world where there's a monarchy and you choose one person from each class to go compete to be the prince's wife, and the girl who didn't expect to win won, and I think that's a really amazing story.
Who would be, I don't think we've asked this, teacher, yes, but role model in life?
My dad and I do everything together. I've always done everything my dad did. I knew how to ride a motorcycle before I knew how to ride a bike because my dad was a motocross racer for 36 years, and he's the one that got me into all of my passions and has helped me the most through my education journey. And so I look up to him, and I hope that students will look up to me in the same way when I preach my platform to them.
Good. That concludes our interview. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to the 2019 Miss Milwaukee Area and Miss Milwaukee Area's Outstanding Teen Competitions. Let Me Be Your Star from the musical Smash. Her favorite portion of her talent is the ending belt because it showcases the power in her voice. Please help me welcome contestant number 4, Anneliese Vass.
Contestant number 4, Anneliese Vass.
Why is it important to explore different ways to learn in a classroom? Each person learns differently, and by taking the 7 different learning styles and using my platform, I can show the children that I am teaching that there are all sorts of different ways that you can learn, and finding the way that you learn best is going to be crucial for the rest of your life and retaining information. Thank you.
Area 20.